Shalom Alechem, it's Echo Ram Shepherd here from King David's Tomb, kingdavidkabbalah.com, and I want to share with you interesting Dvar Torah of Or Chaim HaKadosh on Parashat Achrei Mot. So first let's look on the Pasuk, okay, the first Pasuk of the Parashat Achrei Mot. מדבר אדוני אל משה לאחרי מות שני בני אהרון מקרבתם לפני השם וימותו. So first of all, the literal translation of that, that Hashem spoke to Moshe after the death of the two children of Aaron, when they came close to Hashem, when they came close in front of Hashem, lifnei Hashem, and they died. Okay. So let's see what Or Chaim HaKadosh says on that coming close to Hashem. Says Or Chaim HaKadosh. נראה לומר שנתכוון באומרו בקרבתם על דרך באותם יותר קרובים להשם מכל. אור החיים הקדוש comes to tell us that when the Torah is telling us that they came close to Hashem, it means that they came closer to Hashem than more than anyone else. הלמדת שאין קרובים מהם, there's no one that is closer than them. שאם היה משה קרוב מהם, if משה רבנו was closer than them, היה הדבר נעשה בו כמו שנאמר לו השם. So the same thing that happened to them would happen to him. Okay? And it says in the Pasuk, בקורבי אקדש, those that come close to me, I sanctify my name upon them. אולי כי כאן ביאר הקדוש ברוך הוא דבריו אל משה. And here, what happened to the children of Aaron, that was the point that Hashem clarified what he told Moshe Rabbeinu. על פי הדברים האלה, אמר משה לאהרון, הוא אשר דיבר השם. And that's what Moshe Rabbeinu told Aaron, that's what Hashem meant when he said, בקורבי אקדש, I will sanctify my name, with those that are climbing closer to him. Okay. Now, I'm skipping a few lines here, okay, that there is a few things that the Or Chaim HaKadosh brings, but I want to read here a little bit lower. דבר זה ימצא בבחינת החושק שייתן נפשו על הדבר. Okay, it's possible to find that aspect of coming close to Hashem when someone have a desire that he's putting in his heart, and he have that desire so strong, even though that he knows, agam sheyeda sheyemut, even though he knows that he will die with that, if he follows that desire, still he follows that. Okay. זה אמר לו וימות ופירוש שכבר מתו ולא השיגו מחשבתן להתקרב. So according to that, they didn't get to that intimacy that they wanted to reach. Okay? That's one possibility, one explanation. Then, after some explanations, Or Chaim HaKadosh follows, comes with another explanation that is what I want to show you. Here. בקרבתם לפני השם, that they came close to Hashem, ואמר וימותו, what does it mean? וימותו, that vav, that is extra, רמז הכתוב, הפלאת חיבת הצדיקים. Okay, that's like something very interesting, the point that he's saying here. The desirable love of the tzaddikim, of the righteous people. Agam sheyu margishim mimitatam lo nimnu mikrov ledvekut. So even though they felt that they are dying because they were like elevating more and more and more, but they did not stop. Even though they felt that they about to die, but they continued to connect to Hashem. And Now the Or Chaim HaKadosh brings very, very beautiful words of the to describe the intimacy with Hashem. Okay? It's very hard to translate those to English, but I'll try. Ne'imut, arevut, yedidut, chavivut, chashikut, metikut. Okay? So, ne'imut is pleasantness. Arevut is something that is delightful, tasty. Yedidut is like friendship. Chavivut is something that you like, that you love. Chashikut is desirable. Metikut is sweetness. So all of those qualities came together. Ad klot nafsham mehem, until they lost their soul. Meaning it's not that they lost their soul. Their body lost their soul. Or their soul lost their body. Because their soul got to those levels in a very extreme way. This aspect, this intimacy, there's no possibility for someone to know that quality. It's impossible to get that conscious. Lo mipi mina enoshi velo mipi katvo. Not from a mouth of someone else, not from any writing. Velo tusag be'asharat muskal hageshem. You cannot get to that by assuming some kind of a parable, some kind of a comparison of physical. Ulamasig chelek me'asagazo, someone that is able to fathom some of that conscious, a little of that taste, tavdil mimeno, that will separate from him, hamonea oto, whatever is preventing him, mihitkabel, to accept that conscious, vetakireu al yedei simanea, and he will be recognized by the signs of that intimacy, of that conscious. Ki ze hafcha menegedet tzon'ea. That level, that intimacy, is a contradiction to whatever is hateful by that. Needs to be explained. What is the hateful? Basically, whatever is contradicting, whatever is pulling the person down back to the physical, is the contradiction of the elevation, right? Ve'tif'al bo peula reshuma, it will act within him a significant work, significant process, lishlol mimeno koach hamon'o, to take away from him the power that prevents him, meaning that prevents him to be elevated. What is the power that is preventing us from the elevation? Is the Yetzara, the evil incarnation. And okay, there is like the evil incarnation and the cause for the evil incarnation. Ve'lefa'amim tema'aseu ha'nefesh v'tariveu meriva gdola. Sometimes the being hates it and fight against it. Ve'u sod holelut ha'nevi'im. And that's what happened to the prophecies, to the prophets, when they were receiving their prophecy, that they were like out of their physical, they were like not conscious, basically, because there's a contradiction with the physical. Ulech shetirbe b'china zo bepnimiyuto, when that aspect will be multiplied within the inner being of the person, תגאל הנפש את הבשר. The being is getting disgusted from the physical body. ויצתה מאימה ושב על בית אביה. So then the soul wants to leave the body and to connect to Hashem, to go back to the world of souls. והודיע למתבונן בפנימיות השכלת המושכל. Now comes Or HaChaim with very, very beautiful words. With the help of Hashem, I hope I'll be able to translate it. He's coming and he says, I will tell you, the one that is observing within the inner aspect of that concept, to try to grasp it, שהשכלת השכל תשכיל להשכלות. Okay? The conscious that is trying to grasp, to fathom, will fathom those concepts, ובהשכל השכלתו, when the mind is getting that concept, that is able to grasp it, yaskil, what the person gets to know, what is the new understanding, the new knowledge that is receiving, שמושכל משולל ההשכל, that conscious is something that is impossible to know. It's a knowledge that it's impossible to know. וכשישכיל בהארת עצמו, when he will know it with his own awakening, ולא עצמו ישכיל, he's not awakening himself, שהמושכל מושכל ממושכל, בלתי מושכל מהשכל. That knowledge is coming from, is an outcome of a higher knowledge, that higher knowledge, it is impossible to know it. והשכילו למשכילים בייחוד, it is knowledgeable to those that have that knowledge with the unity. Okay, ייחוד, that's a very, very important point here, to get to unity. Then someone can approach the knowledge. השכלתו בסוד נשמה לנשמתו. And then he will know that knowledge, and that will be a soul to his soul. He will elevate, connect to his soul, and to the soul of the soul. ואז מותריו יהיו יתרי מלכים וכסאם. In that point, whatever remain by him is the crowns of the kings and their thrones. כי יש חיים לחיים, there is life to life. שלם אמר משה ובחרת בחיים, and that's what the Torah is telling us. משה רבנו is telling us, you have to choose life. בית המודעות, the play, the house of consciousness, ושוללת חיים הנשתבים בהרגש הכללי, and that higher conscious, the life of life, the soul of soul, is preventing and contradicting life of the lower life of the physical. ויברך ברוך אלוקים חיים אשר סיגל סגולה זו לסגולתו. And then when a person is getting to that point, he can say blessing to Hashem the life living God that gave that prestige, that merit to Am Yisrael, which is Am Segula, have that potential, have that possibility, and that's the unique strength, the unique elevated possibility that there is for someone that is connect to his soul. So there is definitely a lot to learn and explain on those words, but for now I will hold it here and I will say blessing for everybody, including myself, that Hashem will give us the merit to be elevated and to connect to those levels, but not to leave this world before our time, before we finish to do the work that we came this world to do, to finish all what we need to do, and then to move on, to connect to the highest of the highest. Thank you very much. Blessings from King David's tomb, kingdavidkabbalah.com, Har Zion, Yerushalayim, Eretz Yisrael, Berachah v'Hatzlacha.